Here are 7 AI laws that I would implement immediately if I was president of Earth. A vote for silly conversations is a vote for not being dead. Number 1, we should ban slaughter bots. I know this is a controversial opinion, but building massive swarms of flying AI-controlled drones designed to locate and kill human beings is a bad idea. I love playing hide and seek. Hooray! There are many categories of weapons that have been banned internationally for being too cruel to soldiers or too dangerous to civilians. Examples include laser weapons that cause blindness, chemical weapons, and weaponized diseases. There is an ongoing movement to ban autonomous weapon systems, but previous talks collapsed back in 2021 due to opposition from the US and Russia. AI-powered killer drones are already in use by both sides in Russia's invasion of Ukraine, and the technology is rapidly improving. Realistically, I think the only way slaughter bots are getting banned at this stage is if some country loses control of a drone swarm and accidentally kills a few thousand civilians. Which would absolutely be terrible, but it's still better than some rogue AI superintelligence potentially seizing control of a fleet of millions of murder machines. Number 2, physical cameras, including those in mobile phones, should have a mandatory digital watermark system that applies an encrypted signature to photos and videos proving they were taken by a real camera and not generated by AI. Invisible watermarks should also be applied automatically to AI images and videos by the tools that generate them. Social media platforms like Facebook and YouTube should then be required by law to clearly show users the status of this watermark. A version of this technology called content credentials already exists and has been supported by various tech companies and camera manufacturers. However, participation is voluntary and adoption has been slow. To be honest, it doesn't really matter whether we use content credentials or something else. Legislators just need to pick a digital watermark standard and make it legally mandatory. Number 3. Any book written mostly by an AI should be banned from sale in physical and online bookstores.
But then you're infringing on the right to freedom of speech.
Sorry, is this ChatGPT's right to freedom of speech? A softer version of this law that would probably accomplish the same thing would be to require every published book to include a detailed breakdown of how AI was used in its creation. Kind of like an AI nutrition label for literature. Major AI companies often store their conversations with users long term, so we could force them to check which newly published books contain text generated by their models. I'm reading Empire of AI by Karen Howe at the moment. It's a detailed account of how OpenAI was created that covers the infighting, the backstabbing, and the slow drift from being a safety-focused non-profit organization to the profit-focused non-safety corporation we all know and love today. Inside my copy of the book, I found this little stamp right here. Gen AI free, certified, 100% human. I like this. Give me more of this. Make it the law. Also, while we're making changes to publishing law, to be listed as the main author of a book, you should have to have written most of the words. So, if ChatGPT or a ghostwriter did most of the actual writing, you can't present yourself as the main author. It's false advertising and it has to stop. This will also have the side benefit of forcing celebrities to give their ghostwriters proper credit. Number 4. No human voices for AI. It's very easy to make a voice sound robotic without reducing its ability to convey useful information. The main use case for AI voices that sound convincingly human is tricking people into thinking they're listening to a human. This technology is great for scammers, AI slop YouTube channels, and companies that want to secretly replace their public-facing human workers with AI. This is especially frustrating when the robot voice you're speaking to on the phone is taking pretend breaths and pretend pauses and making pretend typing noises. These companies are making their bots less clear on purpose to trick me. Consumers should always know if they're speaking to a person or to a machine, so robots should be legally required to sound robotic. Number 5. Robots can't look human. A favorite pastime of robotics companies is building creepy robots that look almost kind of sort of human. If you think we should allow this technology to develop until we have perfectly realistic humanoid robots, you have clearly never seen any science fiction media ever. Stop giving robots human skin tones. Actually, stop giving them skin! A droid that looks like this can do manual labor just as well as one that looks like this, but without the massive societal and psychological implications of owning something that looks like a person, or wondering if certain people are secretly robots. Which brings me to rule number 6, no rights for robots. Robots are not people. Robots will never be people. They cannot have citizenship, they cannot have voting rights, they cannot have any rights at all, ever, under any circumstances, ever. This kind of nonsense cannot be tolerated.
But look, I built this little robot who can feel pain and joy and...
Ah, no, please!
Delicious. There are some philosophical systems, like utilitarianism, in which an AI would deserve rights if it could experience suffering. However, my philosophical system defines moral good as that which benefits humanity. And giving rights to robots not only doesn't benefit humanity, it's a clear step towards replacing ourselves and going extinct.
That's just speciesism!
Yes, I am a speciesist. Fight me for the future, nihilism boy! And finally, number 7, we need to ban AI superintelligence. A superintelligence is what you get if you let AIs do unsupervised AI research. Basically, the AI builds a smarter version of itself, and this new version is better at doing AI research. So, it builds an even smarter version of itself, which builds an even smarter version of itself, faster and faster, until you've created an unfathomably powerful AI superintelligence. To be clear, it's this uncontrolled self-improvement loop leading to superintelligence that I want to ban, not AI research in general. Before becoming a YouTuber, I was a machine learning researcher for a quantum computing company, and it was super fun. It may surprise you to hear that I actually like this technology, at least in theory, and I personally believe that AI is going to drive a lot of scientific progress in the near future. However, I want that progress to be driven by highly specialized, strictly regulated, controllable AI systems. I also like nuclear energy, but I recognize that it's a potentially dangerous technology that needs to be heavily regulated in the interest of public safety. And if that slows down innovation, so be it.
AI keeps accelerating, and over the past few months, we've begun to see glimpses of AI systems improving themselves. So developing superintelligence is now in sight.
Obviously, Mark Zuckerberg has a vested interest in getting the public to think that superintelligence is right around the corner. Meta is a publicly traded company, and he's pouring massive amounts of shareholder money into AI infrastructure and stealing nerds from OpenAI. Still, AI models really are getting better at computer programming, and superhuman general-purpose AI has gone from being speculative science fiction to an active area of industrial research. Zuckerberg, of course, has a plan for what to do with superintelligence once it exists.
There's this big open question about what we should direct superintelligence towards. A lot has been written about the scientific and economic advances that AI can bring, and I'm really optimistic about this. But I think an even more meaningful impact in our lives is going to come from everyone having a personal superintelligence that helps you achieve your goals, create what you want to see in the world, be a better friend, and grow to become the person that you aspire to be.
Here at Nuclear Bombs Incorporated, we think that everyone should have their own personal nuclear weapons. Use them to mow your lawn, clean your room, and remove tough stains from indoor carpets. To be honest, this personal superintelligence stuff seems like marketing hype to me. Like, what does it even mean to give individual people control of an AI superintelligence? How is it supposed to help you be a better friend? Here's Mark's letter explaining the idea. You can pause and read it if you want. I really don't get it. If anything, Mark's plan provides a strong argument for strictly regulating AI and banning superintelligence, so that the future of humanity is decided by governments and citizens, not whichever tech bro wins the race to develop superintelligence. Even Sam Altman, the CEO of OpenAI, has repeatedly said,
"And the bad case, and I think this is like important to say, is like lights out for all of us."
Real talk, in what universe does it make sense to allow private companies to develop a technology that their own CEOs believe could kill everyone in the world? Like, what are we doing here? Based on this extremely scientific and unbiased poll I conducted, most people, or at least most of my viewers, are in favor of a ban on superintelligent AI. The easiest way for this to happen is for the US and China to cut a deal to ban the development of AI systems that could improve themselves, or other AIs, beyond human-level general intelligence. China already has some laws governing the development and use of AI, and based on their recent statements, the Chinese government is taking AI safety seriously. Back in April, Xi Jinping called for extensive international cooperation on AI. Donald Trump, meanwhile, prides himself on his reputation as a dealmaker, and it's well known that he wants a Nobel Peace Prize. Now, I'm no expert, but creating an international treaty that could potentially save our entire species from extinction seems pretty Nobel Prize-worthy to me. The US and China already dominate the existing AI industry, and they're probably geopolitically powerful enough to bully the rest of the world into accepting chemical weapons-style restrictions on the development of superintelligent AI. Of course, the more countries get on board with a ban on superintelligence voluntarily, the more likely it is to succeed. I know it can sometimes feel like AI will inevitably ruin our societies and then destroy the world, and there's nothing we can do about it. But we do actually have good options to stop this from happening. This list only contains a very small fraction of the actions we can take to help ensure a better future for humanity. If you think this message is important, you can like and subscribe to boost this video in the YouTube algorithm. Any of these topics could have been a full video by itself, so let me know in the comments if there's any in particular you want to hear more about. This video was brought to you by my wonderful backers on Patreon. I appreciate you all very much, and I'd like to give an extra special thank you to those in the Big Sentient Hat Tier, who you can see right here, and also the Sentient Hat Tier, who are listed in the description down below. You know, when I launched my Patreon in the last video, I was kind of expecting to get no signups, and then I was going to make a joke in this video about how the patron wall is empty, and you all hate me. But no, it turns out that there are a bunch of people who like silly conversations enough to pay money so that I can make more of it. Thank you all so much. Fun fact, I have been awake for 24 hours as of the recording of this audio, and I do not feel good. I hope you couldn't tell. That's all for today. I'm Silly Conversations. See you all next time. Bye for now.